Everything has a genesis and an end. Genesis, Adam, Eve, betrayal that led to the beginning of sin. Humanity, birthed into iniquity and spreading it just like a virus to our descendants and generations to come. Coronavirus. Carrier number one turns into millions and counting. Human irresponsibility. I mean, Adam, you were given the command not to eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil before God gave you Eve. Deception. Deception came from a broke, busted, and disgusted dude who had time to craft a persuasive speech in her DMs on how she won't die, but her eyes will be open to being like God, knowing good and evil as soon as she takes a bite of the apple to eat. Sin, it tastes so sweet at first, opening the eyes of mankind and spreading through pride, greed, wrath, envy, lust, gluttony, and sloth. Lord, please forgive me. You knew, though, so you paid the penalty on a cross with your blood as an act of remission, showing one of the many attributes of a good leader, sacrifice, going beyond a feeling and doing what's right for humanity. Abuse of power and authority in the midst of a world pandemic has revealed the hearts of many. God, your love is the remedy. Showing up in the hands, hearts, minds, and abilities of people through countless acts of love. Thank you for providing us with PPE, personal protective equipment, that not only included masks, but the full armor of you. Finding Christ in a crisis felt like it was easier to find a needle in a haystack. Overwhelmed, under pressure, unpredictable, but this was worse than a change in the weather. A pandemic in my lifetime erased a calendar of plans that held some long-awaited blessings. I know everyone's love language isn't physical touch, but this pandemic has everyone missing the physical touch so much. Introverts got converted to extroverts. Clothes in the outside apply pressure to marriages that appear solid because pre-COVID time apart hid parts of the union that wasn't revealed inside the house and the heart. Being single with no one in the house turned spaces into closed-in walls. Mental health at stake, routine out of whack, shift adjustments, lack of faith. God heard the voices of his people now more than ever, waiting to see how the pause on earth was going to affect and reset life for us all. Your word and your presence was my spiritual immunity against the disease of a virus that invaded all sense of normality. World travel, business, restaurants, entertainment, essential workers, unemployment, hospitals, death, ventilators, last breaths, funerals, families, corporations, inclusion and diversity, police brutality, universities, online church, online work, online dating, quarantine. Dear God, we're tired, growing weary, so many deaths, burdened souls. But no matter how crazy things seem, you're still in control. You have overcome the world, and no matter what happens, this I do know, that nothing will ever trump you being God. Nothing. Not even a pandemic.